Hello friends and welcome to Digimento. Today we are taking a deviation from the topics that we were discussing till yesterday. Till yesterday we were dealing with people, development and environment, but today we will be taking a deviation from what we were learning till yesterday. So today we'll be discussing about a very, very important topic, a very important topic from your examination perspective and also from the current affairs perspective. So today we will be discussing about new education policy of 2020. So we will be discussing this in detail. It may take some more time. Usually we have like 40 to 45 minutes of live session every day, but today it may take some more time because the topic is little lengthy and there are 27 points to be covered. And why I am teaching you this in detail is because you are preparing for NTA NET examination. So for NET examination, the objective of the examiner is to check your teaching ability in the paper 1 especially. In the paper 2, the subject expertise will be checked, but in paper 1, your teaching aptitude will be measured. So new education policy is something that every aspirant for the NET examination should be aware of. So that's why we will be discussing this in detail. So this may take some time. Please bear it with me. I will try to finish it within the time limits, but if it goes longer or like if the lecture gets extended, please bear it with me. So let's start. Before that, this is our channel and we are also providing online courses for GATE, NTA, UGC, NET and PGT Computer Science. You can visit our website www.digimentor.com or you can call to any of these this number or the earlier number that was given. So for more inquiries or like, you know, if you have any doubts, you can call us in any of these numbers. And also please do subscribe to our channel if you have not yet subscribed to our channel. Also please press the bell icon for getting the notifications, and also share the video with your friends if you feel that this is a helpful video. So let's start. Let's come to the new education policy of 2020. Okay, so we'll be discussing all the details, all the 27 points of the new education policy. I will try to make it more interactive. Since this is a policy document and also these topics that we are dealing today, it's all policy related. I know it's a bit boring because the subject is a little dry and there is no scope of, you know, adding fun to it. But I'll try to make it more interactive, you know. So let's see. First one is about the new pedagogical and curricular structure, the structure. So you know that until now the structure, the curriculum that we follow, it's called 10 plus 2. So 10 standard is your basic matriculation. So 10 plus 2. So this is the curriculum that we follow. The 10th or the 12th standard, it can be of the state board or it can be from, you know, CBSE schools or CBSE syllabus or the ICSE syllabus, it can be anything. So the right now what we call is 10 plus 2. This is what we call the curriculum. So here a modification has been recommended or has been brought in. So this modification will be that now the new pedagogical and the curricular restructuring will be 5 plus 3 plus 4. Now earlier when it was 10 plus 2 until 10th, that is until the 10th class or matriculation, we considered it as a, like, you know, holistic approach till the 10th class. Now plus 2 means the 11th and 12th, the senior secondary schooling that you do. So this was the earlier scenario. Now this will be made, you know, more broad based, making it 5 plus 3 plus 3 plus 4. We will see what are these 5 plus 3 plus 3 and 4 and all, everything we will see that. But before that, let me tell you one thing. This was a very, very much needed change. And you know, the new education policy, when we discuss this policy till the end, you will understand that this is a kind of structural reformation that the government has brought into the education sector after a very long period, and therefore it's a welcome step. So we need to study it, all the policies, especially because you're preparing for NET and you have a subject or a topic called teaching aptitude. So new education policy is very, very important for you. So first of all, the first thing that you need to understand is that these changes were much required changes, most welcome changes. So this is the attitude that you should keep in mind when we learn about this policy. Okay, currently children in the age group of 3 to 6 years, so those children who are attending the kindergarten or the play schools. So children between 3 to 6 years are not covered in the 10 plus 2 structure, as class 1 begins at the age of 6. So until now, one major change in the new policy is that until now, those children who are between the age group of 3 to 6 years, they may be attending play schools, they may be attending kindergartens, but they were not calculated as, or they were not considered to be a part of the formal education system. Until now, the formal education begins from class 1 and at the age of 6. But in the new structure, it's 5 plus 3 plus 3 plus 4. So here, a strong base of early childhood care and education from age 3 is included. So from age 3, they are considered to be a part of the formal education system. For example, I have a daughter who is like 4 years. So she is attending a play school and now she will be in the LKG. So basically, the school that she attends or the play school, the kind of education that she attends, it's not considered to be a formal education until now. But now what will happen? She will also become a part of the formal education system. So this is the first major change that has been brought in. Now, the early childhood care and education. So we said that those children between the age of 3 to 6 years, now at the present, in this present system, they are not considered to be a part of the formal education, but now the provision has been made ECC, that is early childhood care and education. So we will see what are the details of it. So how it becomes the foundation of learning. The numerous rich local traditions of India developed over millennia in ECCE, involving art, stories, poetry, games, songs and more, will also be suitably incorporated. If you see any play school or the kindergarten syllabus, you will see that the children are not taught arithmetic or, like, you know, not even a language or nothing in the play schools especially. What they do, they teach them stories, painting, poetry, some skills, some songs, games. This is kind of like, you know, introduction to the formal education system. So in this ECC or early childhood care and education, the government plans to impart all these local traditions of India. The art we have, the culture we have, or the music, painting or poetry, stories, all these will be incorporated in the early childhood care and education. 6 months training for ECC qualification for current 10 plus 2 Anganwadi teachers, and 1 year course for teachers with lower qualification. Now this is the educational qualification required. So 6 months of training for those who have completed 10 plus 2. So currently those who are working as Anganwadi teachers who have completed their 12th standard, a 6 months of training will be given to be qualified as ECCE teachers. And for those having lesser qualification, that is those who have not completed their 12th standard, they will be given 1 year course for this ECCE. So that is the plan. The planning and implementation of early childhood care and education curriculum will be carried out jointly by the Ministry of HRD, that is Ministry of HRD, Human Resource Development, Women and Child Development, and Ministry of Family and Health and Family Welfare and Tribal Affairs. So these are the nodal agencies or the ministries that are responsible for implementation and planning of the ECC. So ministries are also very important. So it's not just by the MHRD. Usually educational policies or implementation of educational policies are done by MHRD, but here, apart from MHRD, Women and Child Development, because this is concerned with the children between the age group of 3 to 6 years. So Women and Child Development Ministry, along with that, Health and Family Welfare and Tribal Affairs. So these two are also added. So these are the implementing agencies. A national curriculum or circular and pedagogical framework for early childhood care and education for children up to the age of 8 will be developed by the NCRT. So NCRT will develop a national level curriculum for this, for implementing this plan. Okay. So here we will see the early childhood care and education, the foundation of learning. So ECC itself is very important. So we will see how it becomes a foundation of learning. So through ECC, the plan of the government is to provide a foundation for learning. Or before they enter the mainstream education, that is from the first standard, they are given a foundation. So What kind of foundation will be given? Physical and motor skills, then socio emotional and ethical skills, communication and early language, cognitive skills, cultural and artistic skills, and numeracy and literacy skills. So these are the kind of skills that will be imparted. Don't think that it is at the higher level, but at very small levels. Now I will give you an example. Let us take the comparison between an Anganwadi, which is run by a government agency, government, and also let's take an international school. So in an international school, there are different categories of students, like the toddlers. So they take admissions from even, you know, 1.5 years. So toddlers will be there, then there will be also play school, then there will be kindergarten. So in the international school, if you see, the children who pass out from the international schools, at the age of 6 itself, they will be very good in language communication, whether it is local language or mother tongue or in English. Again, the literacy skills will also be high. Then cognitive skills, also the kind of skills that they develop is very high. That is because there is a provision of trained teachers in these international schools. But if you compare it with a locally run Anganwadi, which is run by the government, we cannot say that the skills imparted will be par with the international school. Now the government wants to bring in equality here. So even though equality is not possible, government wants to reduce the gap, and government wants these facilities which are available at a very high standard school, or what we call as international school, even at the government institutions like the Anganwadi. And for that, the government will be implementing a new curriculum which will be developed by the NCERT. Okay, let's see what are the early childhood education institutions. One is standalone Anganwadis, that is independent Anganwadis. Anganwadis co-located with primary schools. So first category is those Anganwadis which are independent, or like, you know, they will not be a part of a bigger school or not even a part of a primary school. They are independent, and mostly the Anganwadis are independent. Then there are also Anganwadis which are co-located with primary schools. That means within the premises of the primary schools itself, there will be Anganwadis. Third is pre-primary to the pre-primary education to for the age group of 5 to 6 years. Then standalone preschools. So these are the four categories of early childhood educational institutions that will be available.